It's so hard, and 61 years. I went to Uluru, and I was there for 5 days before I went into Alice Springs. And at the Rock, I made a promise that I wouldn't smoke again.
Smoking cessation is terribly important for our patients diagnosed with lung cancer. And I often find that patients can have a nihilistic approach, feeling that the damage has already been done, they've been diagnosed with lung cancer, so what's the point of quitting now? But in actual fact, recent research in the British Medical Journal has confirmed what we've always thought, and that is quitting smoking has lots of benefits at any stage in your cancer journey, from the time of diagnosis to through your treatment. In fact, patients diagnosed with cancer, regardless of the stage or how advanced the cancer is, we've recently found are twice as likely to be alive in 5 years if they can stop smoking at the time of their diagnosis.
They gave me these different tablets that had come on the market, and I just decided to give up, you know, because my kids, like, they, it was sort of for them too, because I had to show them that, you know, I was trying, you know, to do the right thing.
My son Richard, he was a smoker, and I don't know why I had this sort of thought. It came to me, I said, here's my opportunity. I said to Richard, I want you to promise me something, and he said, yeah, sure, what is it, Dad? I said, you give up smoking. And he hasn't smoked since, so that's a good part of the story of the surgery anyway.
Your GP is probably a good start to get some advice on quitting smoking, or even your local pharmacist who can give you some advice on whether to use some patches or get some prescription medication from your doctor.
But I've been off it now 5 days with the patches, and I'll stop completely now.
There are lots of ways available for patients to stop smoking. Perhaps the most important thing is to realise it might take more than one attempt. We often say to patients, quit, quit, and then quit again until they're eventually successful. And the help ranges from support of family and friends, perhaps who've already been successful quitting, to professionals, not just doctors, but nurses, the local doctor, the specialists involved in one's cancer care, all have resources to help with the quitting process. And then there are also things like the quit line. Patients often find helpful contacting and getting further support there as well.
If you can avoid smoking as early as you can, and start reading or listening to your body.